We're now in Nauvoo at the Nauvoo, some of the homes park in the old Nauvoo area. It's like we've got the Quincy River just in front of the, I think they call it, the Joseph Smith home. That's the spring house that we're panning by. And the original log cabin that the Smiths lived in is right there. And as we pan around, the mansion house is directly in front. We'll zoom in on that. And it's very well restored. It's essentially all original. And this was and it ended up being a hotel, but the hotel portion is gone. This was to originally be three stories above the foundation. Actually ends up being three stories now, and a portion of it to the south has been totally removed. And as we pan on around, this is a dike apparently for protection from the river, which I don't think is really needed because there's a dam downstream. And as we go around, we'll end up where we started. Now we're back by the homestead house. That's the spring house again, with Joseph and Hiram and Emma's actually gravestone right there, that marble stone you see. And that's the Smith Cemetery behind that picket fence. And you can see the old original log cabin portion and the two additions, one to the north and one to the west. There. And what a beautiful big oak tree in the middle of the yard. The mansion house again, what's left of it, the original part, and what seems to have lasted the best. And the hotel site. Okay, there we go. You can see this is the Smith family cemetery. In Nauvoo again, with the mansion house across the corner there. As we pan back, we're now on Water Street, looking at the original cabin, and then the cabin on the far side, and the two additions to the building. And this is the cemetery. And much of the Smith family has been buried here. There's a plaque indicating who are here. And as we look across the Mississippi, a little bit bright. That's the red brick store. Red brick store that was run by Joseph Smith. And they have artifacts and other products that they would sell at that time. The rooms upstairs, that's a large room in the front of the store. And where they say they made all the plans for the Nauvoo Temple and other places. And then I'll pan around to the Pioneer Home, or the Homestead they called it, for the Smiths. This is a large plaque to greatness. It says, near here, the Mormons' exodus to the Rocky Mountains began on February 4th, 1846. In 7 years, members of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints community called the Mormons had built Nauvoo to a size comparable to Chicago. It says here on the plaque, self-appointed bodyguard for Joseph Smith, served for many years as sheriff and marshal in Salt Lake County, and kept a mail station near Point of the Mountain, where the Utah prison now stands. He risked his life many times in defense of church leaders. Joined the church in 1930, the same year it was founded. that this was his property. The house no longer stands, but this was his property on this corner. And we're going to pan in a better position. We're looking at a little better position at the Heber C. Kimball home. All of these are closed. It's in the evening of Saturday, the 16th of July, 1994. What a beautiful old home. See the, I guess they call those widow walks or whatever up on the top. Beautiful appointments. What a task, or what a heartbreaker it must have been to have to leave all of this and head west. Beautiful home. We're in the women's garden near the Nauvoo Visitor Center. What a beautiful garden.
Family and community. She bears, nurtures, loves, trains, and teaches her own children and family while she blesses and uplifts many others. The good she does extends from generation to generation. She and her husband, acting as equal partners in marriage, help each of the family grow strong. Women leave a rich legacy that links past, present, and future in timeless bonds of faith in God and self, as well as service to God and others. A woman's fulfillment comes from her individual efforts and her contributions to those she loves. Daughter of God, and is thus of infinite worth. Her potential for personal growth is great throughout her life. All through her life, each woman has opportunities to develop spiritually through prayer, scripture study, good works, and education. She enriches her family, community, and society as she enhances her own talents and contributes in and out of her home. As a wife and mother, she can know that God has provided a plan which makes it possible for her family to be together eternally. Nauvoo is the birthplace of the Relief Society, the women's organization of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. It was organized in 1842 to enable women to unite and concentrate their effort to serve. Emmett Smith, wife of the prophet Joseph Smith, was the first president of the organization. In the early days of the church, the Relief Society was established for the spiritual development of women. It taught them about their divinely held capacities for lifting and nurturing the lives of others, for growing spiritually and intellectually, and for developing new skills. Today, the organization continues to spiritually bless each woman. It builds faith and hope in God, emphasizes developing and exercising charity, strengthens all types of families, and enjoys a diverse membership of women with many talents and abilities. The Relief Society has a membership of millions of women in more than 125 countries and territories throughout the world. Women today still adhere to the original motto of charity never fails, as they carry out many acts of service in homes, neighborhoods, and communities.
Of Nauvoo in the visitor center, looking straight south across the Mississippi as it was at that time. And as we zoom in, you can see the streets and then the temple in the center. Up on the hill in the city, and if we're going straight west along the shoreline, you come to the area that where the Smith home was.
The height of its development by the Latter-day Saints. When they began arriving here in 1839, the Latter-day Saints found a few scattered settlers living along the riverbank in a small flat area known as Commerce. Church leaders bought ample tracts of land on the flat from William and Hugh White, and land speculators Isaac Galland and Morris Hotchkiss. The Latter-day Saints laid out streets square with the compass, then divided 4-acre blocks into city lots. Other Latter-day Saint developers gradually expanded the city flat eastward toward the prairie, where farmers broke the sod to plant corn and other grains. Nauvoo became a boom town surrounded by hundreds of acres of new farms. Homes could not be built fast enough to supply the needs of converts to the church arriving from other parts of North America and the British Isles. From the river came a steady stream of immigrants, visitors, and manufactured goods. By 1845, Nauvoo boasted 12,000 residents. In addition, Nauvoo became a thriving business community. The focus of Nauvoo life was the building of the temple. Built by the tides of time and means over five arduous years,